Notice I've got all my love, all my love, all my love as three identical slides. So if I click on this and go to the next one and the next one, it is not at all obvious that that's what happened, that I switched. So the congregation might be confused. They might think, am I supposed to sing that again, or did they get behind? What's going on? Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, what to do when you have identical repeating slides in ProPresenter. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever been in a situation where you've had two slides in a row that were absolutely identical, and so when you changed from one to the other, it wasn't obvious that you changed from one to the other, go ahead, tell me about it in the comments below. Like and subscribe as well. So this is something that has actually changed over the years since ProPresenter was announced. And this was actually one of the things I really, really loved about ProPresenter when I first started using it in the ProPresenter 3 days. And that is when you went from one slide to another, if they were identical, there was a visual indication that that had happened. But it's no longer the case. So let's head over to my computer and I'll show you what I mean by that. So here we are in ProPresenter, and I have actually messed with Alabaster Heart. I've got it on easy view mode here. This is probably the way that most people normally see things, but I did it just so that it's a little more obvious. So notice I've got all my love, all my love, all my love as three identical slides. So if I click on this and go to the next one and the next one, it is not at all obvious that that's what happened, that I switched. So the congregation might be confused. They might think, am I supposed to sing that again, or did they get behind? What's going on? It's a distraction we don't need to have. So what are some ways that we could deal with that? Well, first off, I could just right click, go to quick edit, and double click in there. There we go. And right before the very first word, just add in a space. Now when I click out of that, notice this looks very similar to the way that it looked before, but when I click here and then go here, you can see it moved. And that's even set with the cut transition. Doesn't matter whether you do cut or dissolve, between identical things, it's gonna look identical. So let me switch to dissolve here just to show you going between these two. Notice that it is identical. So if you go from there to there, notice that it does dissolve between those. So that's one thing that you can do. You could also, I'm going to right click here and select edit slide. And what we can do is we could also add in a little bit of a delay between the slides just on this one. So when I go to the second copy of All My Love, I'm going to select this particular text box, and then I'm going to go to build, add a build in. And let's keep it as a dissolve, but here, let me hide myself down here. Change this to, instead of on click, do after transition, and let's add just a little bit of a delay, like a tenth of a second delay here. So if we go back here. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend For more details, head on over to tdm.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to tdm.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. And now I do it. I go from here, it disappears, and then it shows back up. So that's something else that you can do. And then going to there. So let me go full screen with this. I think this is an audience screen, so let's change to my audience preview here. Let's make sure. Yep. Okay. So I'm going to start with this one, go to this one and this one just to compare what those look like full screen. So this one now goes away and then comes back basically almost immediately. And then from this one to the next one, it moves just a little bit. So either way, that's going to give you a little visual indication that no, I didn't forget to change the slides. No, it's not the case that a mistake was made. In fact, what's actually going on is, hey, we're good. We have we've switched between these identical slides. So pick the one that works best for you, or don't use it at all. But either way, those are some different ways to do it. It is, by the way, the case that I will begrudgingly admit that while I don't like the advanced transitions, I find them kind of distracting. This might be one of the few situations where if you don't like either of those other ones, maybe you want to use an advanced transition. So what I mean by that is if I right-click on this, go down to transitions, then I can add a different transition. I would probably still want to keep it kind of basic, so maybe use a fade instead of a dissolve. A lot of times people say, hey, I'm using fade, when in fact what they want to use is dissolve here. So let me show you how that is. So that would basically do the exact same thing as this. So right there. Here, let's try that. Actually, let me do this. Okay, and now here, and now we go to here. Yep, so that's what it did. Is exactly the same one. It wasn't immediately obvious in the preview up here, but that's another strategy that you can use. I probably wouldn't use the cube spin or the amoeba or some of the more distracting ones, but that is another quick way that you could do that as well. If you're in a situation where you think that the words apparently not changing would be distracting to your congregation, you could do a little something to where it's more obvious that they've changed. If you like this, then you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Till next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from Trinity Digital Media and Church Tech U, reminding you to go out and change eternity.